Hello and welcome back to another episode of On My Mind by Meher. In today's episode, Prachi Gole and I have talked about all things music, love, art, creativity. So I hope you guys really like today's video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Let me know if you like these type of podcasts in the comments. Enjoy! Hi Prachi, welcome to the podcast. How do you feel?
Feeling really happy. Thank you for inviting me. You're like a celeb.
You are a very famous singer. I want to just start with like your journey with music. How did it really begin as a kid? Maybe you can tell everybody a little bit about yourself and then start about how your journey with music began.
Okay, so I'm from Bangalore. My name is Prachi Gole and my family's from Maharashtra, but then my dad just had a job in Bangalore, so then we just relocated there. I've stayed in Bangalore for like till I was 18. So okay. South Indian by heart.
So andar se South Indian, bahar se Maharashtrian.
So bahar se Maharashtrian, andar se South Indian. So full like Kannada porgi, like it's like half and half.
Okay.
But I started music when I was like really tiny, basically. Like my dad is a harmonium player. So he's like very much into music. He can't sing, but he has a really great ear for music.
Right.
So I feel like he pushed me to, you know, not just pursue music, just learn music. He's just like, you know, explore it, see if you like it. And first of all, I was a really naughty kid when I was tiny. So the first motive was not to, you know, make her sing, make her famous, this, mm-hmm. that. It was to please sit in one place
mm-hmm.
for 1 hour. Please, yeah. just do this for us. So my mom used to drive me to, you know, classes like every week, you know, 2 times a week and all. It's stressful for parents, like doing this for a kid who's like 7.
Right.
So she used to drive me for classes and it just continued. Like I just liked it. Like I didn't have like a, you know, the interest gradually, you know, went higher and higher. I wasn't like, you know, that serious about it till I was in like, you know, 8th standard. Where, you know, my dad was like, you know, now you need to choose, like, do you want to pursue it as a career or do you want it to be something that you just do it for, you know, as a hobby or as something, as a time pass. So at that point, I was just like, you know, when I was in like 10th, I had to choose ki science lena hai, you know, commerce lena hai.
Yeah.
So I was interested in computer science. So, I was like, okay, science leti hu. But then when I took science, I didn't realize how less time it would
give me
to, you know, pursue my music. So those 2 years, I had to practically stop.
Oh no.
Yeah, okay. it was kind of sad.
Yeah.
But then after the 11th and 12th, I kind of realized how much I like music.
Right.
Because if like it's not there in your life for 2 years, you realize how much you really like it. In school, I can say that I wasn't that good. Like honestly, if you see my videos.
Well, I mean, music is something, again, that brings me to another thing that I always wonder about. Do you think that music is something that people are born with, or do you think it's like something that can be developed over time?
Definitely some people could be born with it, but like you can always inculcate it, like definitely with practice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I would say that there are some people who are special enough to have this talent, but obviously they have to develop it for it to, you know, turn into something incredible.
Yeah.
Like.
Right. So you also mentioned that you started music because you were a very naughty kid.
Yeah.
And so I also know that you are trained in Hindustani classical.
Right.
So that obviously it's taught with a lot of discipline.
Definitely.
And that shows in a person's behavior as they grow up as well.
Mm-hmm.
So do you think that that really changed you as a person growing up? Because that happened at those crucial years of your life. You kind of developed a sense of discipline and, you know, like going on a track, knowing how to follow a routine, you know, practicing. There's a lot of, I forgot the word for it, but
Riyaz.
Yes. There's a lot of dedication and like Riyaz that goes into it. So do you think that's a big part of, even now doing science, all of these things, managing so many things at once, it needs discipline.
Definitely.
So do you think that plays a role?
So when I was small, I didn't realize the importance of, you know, I used to have so many conversations with my dad, why aren't you teaching something cool, you know, I want to be cool, I want to learn Western music, like, please teach me Western music. I didn't understand the importance of the basics of music, and now I realize it, because that time I had my basics cleared, like, from the start. I'm really blessed to have, like, amazing teachers in my life, so I feel like they really guided my music journey, and I feel like they really shaped who I am today. And I feel like definitely there's some place where I realized ki, you know, before when I used to do riyaz every day, I used to get shouted at every day, like, Prachi, why don't you do riyaz? You're not, you know, dedicated enough. I used to get guilt tripped every day. Okay. Every day. I hated doing riyaz, but now it's become like an everyday thing.
Yeah.
It's like how you get up and drink your coffee every morning. So what I do is I get up, I drink my coffee, I sit and do riyaz for like half an hour. Even that half an hour every day for 3 years, if you just do it right, the amount of tehrav you have in your voice. Tehrav is basically the control of your voice, the tonal qualities, how easily you can change your voice pattern, structure, the, you know, shrillness and everything. You can just see how easily you can control it after a point.
So
I feel like riyaz is the most important.
And it's always important. It's not just important in the first
few years. Might be really boring in the start. And might be really boring while you're doing it.
And do you
then
enjoy it a lot now? Like, is it something that you look forward to? Like, how when people talk about meditation, in the beginning, it's very difficult to get yourself to come.
It is, you know, just like
a
calm.
Yeah, so is it like a meditative thing for you?
Before, I used to get annoyed because it's the same. So it's like, so basically how riyaz goes normally, what my teachers have taught me, it's like there are 7 notes. So it's like, sa-re-ga-ma-ba-da-ni-sa-sa-ri-da-ma-ma-ni-sa. So then all these notes. So all these notes, you just have to sustain them. So just you have to extend them for as long as you can. So when I was not good at it, obviously I didn't enjoy the process.
Yeah.
So when, you know, I started getting, you know, better and better, I started enjoying the process even more.
That's very similar to meditation. When people begin their journey of meditation, it's very similar. You know, because in the beginning it's so hard, it's so boring, you can't get yourself to come there. But after a time when you achieve that, then you always look forward to it each day.
Do you meditate?
Yeah, a little bit. I have been. You have?
I just started.
That's amazing.
I do guided meditation.
You do? Really, which one?
So, Headspace. Okay. I've tried Headspace. I've tried loads of them. Like, I probably can't remember now. But there's something on Netflix also. I've done that too.
So since, I didn't know this about you. So since you do meditate, do you think that in a way brings more calmness to you when you actually sing and, you know, like, put that energy into your, like, music and art?
Definitely.
Yeah.
So I feel like it helps me in my classical music. So, like, it just calms your head. Like, there's, like, no thoughts. And if you sing, like, one note while you meditate, it's crazy.
Wow,
it's
okay.
Crazy.
So you can draw, like, a combination of music and meditation.
You can, like, combine the two. Like, obviously, while you meditate and sing a note, it's, like, two different things at once. Probably it takes you a while to gain that balance between the two. But then it's really nice. It feels very calm. Especially if you put tanpura. You know what a tanpura is, right?
No, please
tell. So tanpura is basically an instrument that guides the pitch of a singer. Okay. Normally in Western music, when you say so, you know, Charlie Puth has perfect pitch, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you know what perfect pitch is? Like any note. If I just, you know, hit this glass with a stick, like if it plays some note, he can just tell you what note that is.
Wow, okay.
So actually nobody can do that. Like, I mean, not nobody, like very less
very
people
good.
Can do that. Like it's like a, that's a born talent. Like you can obviously inculcate it, but it's very, very hard. It's incredibly hard.
Yeah.
So what a tanpura does, it keeps you on bass. Like that's your bass note. That's called the sa. Like it keeps you in the same pitch throughout your this one. So it's also very calming to hear. So it's na 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 na. I don't know if you've heard it in like classical recordings or even like Kabira and all has it in the beginning. It sounds really nice. So especially when you're meditating, if you put it in the background, your brain, like the frequency does something.
Right,
100%.
Yeah, I've tried a few like meditations like based on music. And it really puts you in another zone. That's I think another big power of music that people kind of overlook. The power it has to actually
calm your mind
and affect you and like help you feel better whenever you're going through anything. It's something that can really be there for you.
Yeah.
So again, that's something that a lot of people, a lot of artists, musicians, singers say that singing is something that is like an expression of their emotions.
Definitely.
So do you think that also helps you, like when you're going through like a tough time or something, do you think that that emotion can come through when you sing?
I forget about things when I start singing.
Yeah?
So now, every day, I have to remind myself. I set alarms ki I have to stop at 2. Like, I have other things to finish. Like, I need to put a stop to this at 2. Like, so I have to put alarms. But like, so obviously, so this means like it really helps me, you know, forget about the anxiety that I have.
Right.
I definitely have a lot of anxiety about stupid stuff.
100%.
Honestly, it's not even, you know, important, or it's not even that big of a deal. Like some people, like, it's not, Prachi, just don't worry about it. It's like, I can't, I literally can't. Like, it's just at the back of my head all the time. So if I start doing music, it's just gone. It's just gone. I just have to do music for that much time and that's it.
Okay, so you're a little bit anxious by nature, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Little bit.
Can you definitely see. I'm always anxious.
Right. So as a musician, I think, what's your process of dealing with like performance anxiety or stage fright? I'm sure it must have reduced now over time.
Can I tell you a story? It's very...
Please.
Oh my God. It's very embarrassing. You know, even my close friends don't know this because I'm so embarrassed of this.
Okay. Please tell us.
So it's my first flop. Like, I went and I flopped on stage. So I was basically... it was my first time performing with Fiddlecraft.
Right.
And it was not our song, but they needed a female vocalist to fill in. Right? So then they sent me the song. And I learned the lines, I learned everything. You know, it was fairly new to me. It takes time for a song to sink in your head.
Of course. Yeah.
Right? So it takes time for you to, you know, develop your own way of singing it. Then after that, you make your own variations in the song. So I wasn't even at that point yet. And I was supposed to go and sing in Hard Rock Cafe. Okay? And it was my first, like, performance in Pune. Like, I'd just moved. And I was so anxious because what if I forget the words? Like... What will I do?
Yeah.
So then what I did was, okay, cool. I'll have a backup plan. I'll take my iPad. I'll write the lyrics on that and zoom in. Okay. So that, and I'll keep it down.
Right.
And while I'm singing, I'm going to look down at it, read. If I forget.
Read and sing.
Right. So I went up on stage. I kept the iPad down. I'm happy. Like, okay, I remember everything. So then I started... Like, you know, the song started cool, like I have to sing, my part's coming. Okay, so I just want to look at the thing before I, you know, start singing. I look at it, the iPad is off. And then I started panicking because the iPad is off. And then I forgot the lyrics because I remembered it before. So then it was my part and suddenly there's silence. I look at Gaurav, I'm like, I don't know. Please sing it for me. So he sang the female part and I'm standing on stage.
Just the entire song.
Just doing nothing. And at the end, I was just supposed to do Alap, which is like Hindustani, random. Like,
yeah.
I had not prepared anything, just on the spot. So that I did. Just did it for a while longer because, well, I didn't do anything before. It was like I was standing on stage for like a 10 seconds of music ka part. Then I came off stage and I'm like, God, that was a disaster. Oh my God, he's never gonna call me again. He's never
that's
gonna want to work
we
with
know
me
that's
again.
That's not true.
That's not true.
I would love to know all about that as well. You signed with Amazon Prime.
Right. I did sign with Amazon Prime.
Yes.
Like Fiddlecraft sang with Amazon
Prime. And you sang with them. So
yeah.
You were on the show called Unpause, I think.
Yeah.
You sang
so it was on the soundtrack.
Yeah. Soundtrack.
For yeah.
Them. So how was that journey like? I mean, I'm sure it must have been a first time doing something like that for you.
Definitely.
So,
I was
how did that
so
come?
Excited.
Yeah.
And he didn't tell me before. So he was like, aisa project hai. Like, you have to sing the female part. I'll give you the words. I'll give you how to sing it. And just sing it for me. He didn't tell me before because he knew.
You want to tell them a little bit about Fiddlecraft? Exactly.
Definitely, yeah. So Fiddlecraft is this folk band, indie folk band.
Yeah.
And I'm really good friends with their lead vocalist, who is Gaurav Sahakulu, and basically the entire band is, you know, we're really good friends and they're so talented. So they gave me a chance to, you know, sing on their song, and it was featured in Unpaused.
Yes.
Yeah. So that was pretty cool.
I think that was last year.
Last year.
So how was your like journey like till that? Did you when that even happened before that happened? Like, did you expect all of this till I kind of just fall into place, get assigned with all these big things?
This was basically something that I wanted to achieve, actually.
Yeah, it was like a milestone.
Yeah, it was like I came into Pune and I'm like, so it's like a new start, right? If mm-hmm. coming to a new city and stuff. Right now I'm staying with my aunt. And I got into Ferguson. It has a great culture for music.
Yeah.
So I thought, you know, acha, let's like, you know, start, get to know a few musicians. Let's, you know, make a few connections and stuff. And I met Himanshu. Himanshu was the first, artist I met in Pune.
Okay.
And he just blew my mind. Like, I found him on Instagram. And then I was exploring his page. And I'm like, aray, he's in my college. So then we met up. And, like, he's also worked with Fiddlecraft in the past. So we made, like, a few connections. I met a few really, really talented artists on the way. But it was like... definitely one of the things I wanted. It was like in my bucket list. I want to work with this band. Second of all, I want, you know, one of my original songs in some you know, movie or show or something. Yet to happen officially. But like individually.
Right.
So or I want like an original album or a song out. So
do you write a lot as well?
I do, not a lot. It takes me inspiration. Like, when inspiration strikes, I can definitely write.
Yeah.
I have a few originals I have written and composed till now. But still yet to record them. And I'm really excited to release them.
Okay, so what inspires you the most? Like, I'm somebody who personally believes that, like, love is one of the most important things in the
world.
And I know it sounds very cheesy. Some people may not really understand where I'm coming from. But, and I don't only mean romantic love. I mean any sort of love. I think it drives every person in the whole world. And at the end of the day, I feel like almost every essentially creative thing, especially creative things,
right,
are always driven by love or revolve around the concept of love. So do you think that being in love, or do you think it enhances your expression of love?
So love can mean different things to different people, right? So it can also mean, it can be in reference to a friendship, it can be in reference to a lover, it can be anything, right? So different songs have different, you know, meanings of
connotations.
So I feel like definitely the more you experience love, the more you try to portray it in your songs, the more you're able to, you know, bring out that emotion in your songs and in your words.
In your voice as well. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And in your, you know, modulations of your voice, you try to bring out those expressions that you're feeling in your, in the words.
Yeah.
So I feel like I should also say one more point. So my singing teacher, so I learn light music from Miss Aparna Sun.
Light music is?
So light music is ghazals and songs and
So
anything.
That's beautiful.
So so there's, I learn classical music and light music. Classical is purely classical, very, you know, textbook, but it has a particular way of going about it.
Mm-hmm.
Light music is like film music and ghazals and stuff. So I learn light music from Miss Aparna Sanji, and she's told me that, I'm from South India, so my Hindi is not the best,
Okay.
Not gonna lie. So then I have, basically she's helped me, you know, improve my Hindi pronunciations, even the way I portray my words. So sometimes if there is, as well, I was learning a song, where there was, the words were something like, I'll say it in English, So this girl is swinging on a swing, and it's like really breezy, and it's feeling really nice. So how you're singing is like, so the way I was singing it is na 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 na, but then she's like, you're swinging, you should feel like a na 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 na. So then you're like, do you see the difference?
Yeah,
like, it's
yeah.
just like na 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 na. You're like, okay, cool. Like, but then if you like, you know, move your vocals in such a way that you actually feel like she's swinging. So then if you relate to the words, you're like, wow.
Yeah, it should check, come across to the other, to the
just,
audience.
You know, doubles.
Yeah.
So it's crazy. Yeah.
Wow. That's really beautiful.
Yeah.
Another thing, I think, touch wood, like, I feel like we're honestly grateful to be in a country like India. Touch wood.
Definitely.
To be in a country like India with so much culture. And I think music is a huge part of Indian 100%. Culture. And again, like, you've been trained in Hindustani classical.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, what is your, like, opinion on all of this? Just in general, like, just Indian culture and its, like, impact on music and you as a person, how has it been for you?
So Indian culture is the richest music culture I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Right? And
like you also mentioned that when you were a kid you wanted to do Western, but now you understand the value of being trained in Hindustani.
Definitely.
Yeah.
So also I would say that it's not like Western classical is like not that great or anything, but like I feel like any classical, if you learn the basics, I feel like you can definitely do a lot better than just learning the notes and directly going to singing songs.
Right.
Like a lot of people have asked me, you know, Prachi, I'm trying to sing this song, like I can't seem to reach this note, or it's just not sounding the way I feel like I want it to sound.
Yeah.
I feel like first of all you have to feel the song, and second of all, like, go to the basics. Like, don't directly start with something that you know your voice can't handle. Just like ease into it.
I think I'm a little guilty of that as well. I'm somebody who's always wanted to sing. Like I grew up, like I was very like dramatic. I always wanted to be like some Bollywood singer or something.
Oh,
I was like a pop star
God.
Or something, like, on stage with the mic, like all.
I can imagine.
That was me, like when I was a kid. I really wanted to do it, but like for some reason I never got a chance to actually like train in music and stuff. Again, I didn't grow up in India, so there was not much of being trained in music and stuff over there, but in Abu Dhabi. So I feel like that's something that I've always wanted to do. But like you said, like there's no alternative to hard work.
Right.
And
for sure.
I feel like somewhere like subconsciously when I'm like, oh, I just want to become a singer. And my friends are also like, you know, you have to work for that. It's not like overnight ho jayega, you pick up, start a karaoke and
but
start
singing. But you know, it's not like from day one I was doing, you know, two hours a day or something. I started from 10 minutes a day.
Yeah.
Barely 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And sometimes I would go weeks without it and I would get yelled at. Nicely. Okay, I was like, you can already sing great. Like, what's the problem?
Yeah.
In 8th standard only. Yeah, like, I'm just, wow. Like, great. So my dad's like, chup chap, bed ke karo riyaz. So I was like, fine, whatever, I'll just do it.
Yeah.
But then that somewhere, like, it, you know, if you do something for like 21 days, it sets a habit.
Right.
So, you know what my dad said, like, he's been after me my whole life, like, ki do riyaz, do riyaz. If I don't do one day, he'll be like, Prachi, yaar, aaj kyun nahi kiya? Like, just set a habit. So it's like a thing that, you know, you brush every day and then you just do riyaz. Like, that's something you should set. So I feel like that's a really good habit that my dad has tried to
So the fact that he's also like musical, you come from a musical family, do you think that makes a little difference, especially growing up? Like, you think that really like motivated you or pushed you?
Definitely.
Because
I feel like when I was so I used to go for this class when I was small. So my dad doesn't, so he can't sing, but he can really point out mistakes in my music and he can give me really good pointers.
Yeah.
Like on how I can improve.
Yeah.
And he tries to really, it's really funny. I make fun of it, like fun of him sometimes for it. But he knows like deep down it's nothing personal. Like, but then he tries to show me how to sing it, but he just can't do it. But then I was like,
but you know where he's coming from. Like,
but I know where he's coming from. And he gives really good advice also. Like,
I feel like
he's given me when I was really tiny, right? So there's a difference between singing na 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 and na 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 na, like with like thoda oomph. Like he tells me how to add. He's like, you know, I remember him giving me advice when I was really tiny. Like he was like, Prachi, the way you're singing is good. Like everything is correct. Everything is on beat. But it's sounding thoda like very monotonous and very robotic. Like everything is on beat, everything is perfect. Like you need to have some sort of originality or some sort of, you know, something to, you know, put you different from like everybody else.
Yeah.
Like you need to have that individuality in your music.
Yeah.
So I was like,
And that is something, and that's something that I noticed still about you. Like even on Instagram, like you, your bio says that you sing songs with a twist, like you cover songs with a twist. And there's always that thing about Prachi in it.
That's,
you know, like
that's
every time
small,
that small thing that makes you a little different, it makes you different from the normal covers out
it
there.
Makes music fun.
It,
I feel like there is you can always sing the same thing that somebody's done, right? Doing something different of that song and making it your own is like, that's the fun part. That's where I have fun.
Yeah, it adds a touch of like yourself in
exactly
it.
So then if you sing that note, if you sing that particular variation, people are like, damn, I've heard that before. Like, exactly.
Okay, so you've already accomplished so much at this age. I mean, quite a bit, I would feel like also. And also, it's not always about tangible accomplishments. You've also grown a lot. And I think each time you practice and make your voice better, that's also an accomplishment in itself. So what else do you what's your end goal in your career with music in the next, 5 to 10 years? What do you want to achieve? Like you said that working with a show or all these things are on
that
your
is
like
definitely
list.
A
what
goal.
Else?
That is definitely a goal. But I feel like I don't think about music as I just need to do this. I want to do this. I just do it I like it. I'm just going to sing it. I'll post it. If it happens, great. If it doesn't happen, cool. Yeah. I just love doing it.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to continue doing it whether it happens or not. And if it happens, it's just something that, has happened because, utter luck
it's not luck, you worked hard for it.
Yeah, definitely worked hard for it, but there are so many people who, also work hard, right? But, definitely would love to sing in a movie or have my own album out and people follow me for me or my music.
So you're also doing computer science?
Computer science.
So did you also pick that because you were interested in it? It's something that you wanted to do, or is it more of a backup, or do you see yourself working in this industry? What is it more?
So right now I'm in a very confused state. So before when I
think we all are with everything going on.
I'm really, really confused at this point. So I feel like I have a very good creative side. So with doing computers, maybe coding was just not it for me. So I thought I'll do BSc and I'll get time to do music also. And if I did engineering, I would have to, it wouldn't leave much time for me to do music also.
Yeah.
So I feel like BSc was a good choice for me.
Okay.
And I did computer science. I was still exploring which part of computer science I enjoy. And I was, working with a bunch of my friends. And we were designing an app and stuff.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah. So so I just got into, designing the user interface and user
Again, your creative
design.
Side
exactly,
kind of came into
exactly.
that as well.
So then I felt like I just got a kick from it. It was so good. So I designed the whole layout of the app, the theme, the structure. Everything was so fascinating for me. I feel like then I at least found a direction. This may be something I'm really interested in. Might be something I want to do in the future. So I'm thinking of changing my major to design.
Wow.
So let's see. So I don't know. I'm still very confused. It's a very big statement to make on a podcast. Not sure, guys.
We're
if I choose computers, just I changed my mind then.
We're holding you to it.
I mean, oh my god.
Okay, so another thing, I mentioned earlier also that it must be difficult to manage doing something so tedious and also doing music. So what advice would you give to young kids who are trying to balance it, kind of trying to figure out their passion, trying to discover whether this is something that they want to do? Younger than you, I get. You're also confused, so no pressure.
100%.
But younger, young
teenagers. So it took me a while to get a hang of it. In school, I was a mess. My teachers were Prachi, please, have some balance. Not I was really bad in school, but I was not the best,
okay?
Right? But then I also wanted to do music. I was always into sports. I was a lot into, all the cultural fests, I was, in. Every period, someone used to be, Prachi, we need you, downstairs. The teacher's are you gonna ever be in class? In class. Sorry, ma'am. Gotta go. But then I used to leave. But then the thing is that it also used to take a little bit of a toll. And used to, I would, end up, in the beginning years at least, I couldn't manage my time properly, but after a while, I guess, I realized not to take too much on my plate. I can just bite whatever I can chew, right? So I've learned to say no, right? Before I used to find it very hard. First of all, I used to get anxious. I used to think about it I really want to, but how do you explain to someone you really want to, but it's just not in my capacity right now.
Yeah, 100%. Right? And that's so important. A lot of people don't want to accept that.
Definitely.
But that's very important. Yeah. So what other piece of advice would you just give to any upcoming singer, anybody?
I would say be consistent and be dedicated to your art. If you're not good enough, I feel practice makes perfect. I 1 year back, I could see myself singing, and I just wasn't satisfied with what I was singing, right? So I just did it a million times till I got it right. So I feel like definitely that will help you get to where you are.
And how do you like get that bounce back mentality from when you're like really struggling and stuff? Like that's something that I think a lot of artists constantly go through.
So rejection is something, or rejection or failure is something you go through like very regularly in this industry. I feel like it's very volatile in that way. I just feel like don't take rejection. Like you get a million chances and you have only one life. You might as well just fail and try again. Like the only way is up. I feel like one of those self-help books, you know. The only way is up. Dedication is key. I didn't know any of this, guys. I was the most, disobedient kid in my class, probably. Okay, but then later, like, after, getting shouted at.
Yeah. And also, like you said, the base is always set, no? You always end up coming back to that. Like, another thing, I don't believe anybody's a good or bad person. People are born that way. Either they're good or they're bad. So, what I'm saying is that you end up coming back to that. You come back to your base. So, with you, your base, your foundation is like
music,
being trained in that discipline. So, that's like deeply rooted in you as a person.
Right.
So, that's something that I think is really big part of you. So, thank you so much.
Oh,
but
God.
Before we go,
yes.
Can you please sing any song that you want? Anything, and just like a few lines of anything.
Okay, yeah. When you
I'm gonna start fangirling right here on the spot.
Okay, so you can tell me one of your favorite songs. I wanna sing something that you like.
Sing that the one that you covered also. Aaj Jaane Ki Sapna.
Aaj Jaane Ki to everybody's heard. Like guys, go see my.
Yeah, I will be linking all of her handles down below. Go support. She's so talented. Please go support.
But thank you so much. But should I sing like a modern filmy song? I haven't decided yet what to sing.
Anything. Whatever your heart says.
Yahi dube dil mere. Yahi hote hai savere. Yahi marna aur jeena. Inviting me on your podcast. Oh my God, I had the best time.
Thank you
Thanks
so much.
Thanks for the orange juice.
Yes. Uh-huh. Cheers.
Cheers.